Hey everybody, how you doing today? I am just in the nether right now working on the dual blaze XP farm here. I was planning to get a lot of this done, or at least try to before I started recording today, and then surprise you and be like, look what I did today, it's amazing, it's all done. But while building this, something weird and interesting has been happening. I put down a layer of fence gates here to trick the mobs up into walking into the air and falling down, because they see them as normal blocks for their pathfinding. But as you just saw there, there's something very strange happening here with the new changes to fence gates, how they can be controlled with redstone. This is causing them to automatically close on their own at random times, randomly, kind of. And the issue is, normally in the game, it will randomly go through chunks and randomly choose blocks to update every so often. I'm not going to give specific numbers because I don't know them offhand, but when it randomly updates one of these, for some reason it decides to close them because they're not being powered right now. Which is a big issue if you're doing anything mob related with these things, like a lot of people do. So, or if you're using these for conveyor belts or any other design, you have to take that into consideration now. Because if that doesn't get fixed, that's a pretty big issue. So all of these will eventually all close on their own because they're not being powered. So, for this, what I'm going to do to fix it is just use signs and get rid of these. But, just something I thought I'd point out to you guys. Hopefully it gets fixed in a new patch. Alright, so the thing I was trying here doesn't seem to be working quite like I hoped it would. This is just a test to see how it would function. I've been trying to set this up without using any pistons to move the blaze around. And I have signs there now. That's to help decrease the time it takes them to fall down the center. And that does help, but I don't know. Just relying on their pathfinding alone to get their way through takes too long. They kind of get stuck in places. They will eventually find their way through, but it just takes a while. So I'm trying to get them to fall down and then go to the end of this tube, and then they would join together and go down another tube, and then up, is what I would like to happen. But yeah, they just... I don't know, I have to use pistons, I guess. I've been trying to avoid using them because, for one thing, they lag the game a bit. You have to choose one of two negative effects. If you have a piston and a solid block to push them, it pushes them good. Occasionally they will glitch into the solid block and then suffocate to death, which is kind of a good thing. But the other issue is just sometimes when they get pushed by the solid block, they take a little bit of damage. For a split second, they will take suffocation damage as it pushes them. And that's why with my other blaze farm there, that they didn't all have the same health, because some of them took damage as they were getting pushed around. Now, if you were to push them with a glass block, they would take no damage from that, but sometimes they get stuck inside it, their head, and they'll be on the pressure plate at the same time, too. And they will totally jam up the system. So there's no good way of moving these guys around, basically, which kind of sucks. Minecarts you can only do one at a time. What I was thinking of maybe doing is pushing them through my tunnel here with the furnace minecarts, but then I did try that in creative mode and it worked well, but the problem is you had to keep feeding it coal. But it is a good way of moving them around long distance, like a whole group of them. So, yeah, I'll have to adjust this, use pistons, and probably have to do that another day because that will take a while. Oh yeah, and with these, the doors and the trap doors don't seem to be closing on their own, but I haven't given it a ton of time either. Although if you put a block next to them and remove it, then they'll close on their own. This door is open right now. If you put a block next to it and remove it, it'll close on its own too. Alright, we're back here, and I have been doing a little bit of polishing around here with the cave, trying to figure things out a little bit better. So before here, you would have to go up and then back down, and now I just cut a slice out of the cliff here, and just walk straight pretty much. So probably going to either get rid of this mushroom farm here or move it over one block just to make it symmetrical. This is, that's where the pressure plate is right there. I would like that to be in the middle of the walkway here and maybe in one block. Not that I really use that, but it would be nice if it aligned properly. I did a little bit on the ceiling. I added this wooden stripe on this side. People never really told me if they like it or not. I kind of like it because it creates harmony, I guess, with the floor. But I would like to have these all along the walls. The wooden stripe and then nether brick stripe, sandstone stripe. Might be a few too many stripes, but I don't think it looks too bad. Yeah. And I put some more grass over here for now. One thing that was suggested in the comments, let me know what you think of this as well, is for me to get rid of this wall over here. So if we go down there, it's only like two blocks wide in a lot of places, and it wouldn't be that tough to get rid of. And if I do, it would open it up to the tree farm, so you would be able to see the tree farm easily from up here. That might be pretty cool. Let me know what you think of that. This ceiling will be a little bit higher. I'm going to try and make a kind of a domish shape to it. And I might put nether brick all around this green UFO thing. I don't think those colors clash too badly. I haven't fixed this yet. I need to do that too. Make a chamber for cows to fall into, a holding area for cows. I'll probably put that over here somewhere, maybe, along with these mobs. Let's see what else. I am eating watermelons now. I've made the switch, I think. It's just so easy to get them now. You just walk in, you're refilled, walk out. It's pretty cool. Okay, and another good suggestion I had was to get rid of the stairs in this slime escalator thing and replace them with these half slabs. So I think I'll do that right now too. And then I think we're going to go to the end. Because there was a few things I didn't try out there. And to my surprise, you guys actually liked the end visit, so maybe we'll do one more. Alright, time for an enchantment break. Figured I should spend the levels before we go to the end here. Running low on picks, so here we go. Level 49. Wow. Wow, man, that is the best pick I've ever got. I think that's like the best pick you can get. That's awesome. Yes! Alright, I got a little bit more done. Oh. Hello. Got a little bit more done here. I put it some more border around the UFO to see how it would look. I think it's pretty good. I like it. Got some sandstone to try it out. Let's see, I put the wood border around here to see how it would look. I'll probably change that a little bit yet. I wouldn't mind having a glass balcony type thing, just a small one so I can walk and look down without worrying about falling off. So I'll probably have fences around here too. I'll try and make it look a little less square. One other thing I want to do before we head off to the end again to do some tests is try out some pixel art here. So I mentioned I wanted to do some Harvest Moon pixel art. I tried doing a cow face from the old SNES Harvest Moon. Could not get the colors to look good. So I tried building in creative mode. Just didn't look quite like I hoped. So I think I'm going to do Minecraft pixel art cows. I'll probably put one over here and see how that goes. Need an 8x8. Woohoo! 8x8. This wall is 13 wide, so it's not going to be symmetrical. Another problem. But I will play around with it and we'll see how it goes. Alright, you ready for it? Here it is. Here's the pixel art. Looks pretty good. I had a little trouble lighting it as the one issue, so I put a wood frame around it with glowstone every so blocks. Don't really like how the glowstone looks. I could have inset the picture one more block, but then, and like have glowstone hidden on the inside, but then it would have been a lot harder to see the picture, I think. If it was in one more block, the frame would cover it up more so. So I think I'll leave it like that. It would be nice if I could put trap doors over the glowstone to make them a little bit less sticking out like a sore thumb, I guess. I don't know, it's kind of cool. So I don't know if I'm going to put more here. I might, but the problem is I have a... I didn't even think of this, but I have a tube here, which is why I didn't put it on that wall. This is what I push the cows down with. I don't really need it, but I don't know. Yep. So that's good. We got pixel art. And that is the dark pine wood, and then that's light oak wood, I guess. And white wool, then light gray, dark gray, and black. So those are the five different colors I used. Anyway, so I'm going to get ready, and we're going to go to the end. There is at least three or four things I want to try out today, hopefully. So I'll get my stuff together here, and I'll set up a bed at that stronghold too, so that when I die, I will be right by the portal. Okay, I got a little base set up here in the stronghold with some stuff. I slept. What's her sound? Get that down. So we're going to do a few tests again today. Again, our goal is not really to beat the dragon yet, although I'm pretty sure I'll need to get free control over the end. But before we do that... Oh, you guys are annoying. Before we do that, we're going to do a few tests again. So... A lot of people seem to be disappointed last time I didn't try to make a nether portal in the end. And also I'm trying to go with no armor this time, because last time I went I didn't take any damage. Really. So we'll see how I fare. Oh, where am I? Fare with no armor here. Okay, where is he? Why is there no boss? What the heck? Oh, there he is. What? I guess you have to get in range before he spawns, maybe. I really can't look at any of these guys or I'm in trouble. So. Yeah, he's doing weird things. Glitching out. I'm looking at you, don't hurt me.
He owned that Enderman. Okay, so... And now the Enderman's chasing him. Gonna try and make a portal real quick here. Did not try this last time because I have heard it doesn't work. So, I wasn't gonna try it. But, you know, a lot of the times I get wrong information, so I really should try and see with my own eyes whether or not it works. So, where is he? That's not a good sign. So, yeah. Oh man, nice lift. So, no. What's our brightness? Doesn't seem like you can have another portal. Although I would think if you were to do it in MC edit and hack in the... Oh boy. The portal... warp blocks, that I bet you it would work. If I was to guess. But legitimately, nope. Okay, so that's one test done. I should get... Maybe I'll try and make another one of these storage minecarts real quick. Nope. Not gonna happen. Not at all. Okay. Okay, so this next test is one I wanted to try last time, but I forgot to, or I ran out of time or something. But I have a almost dead silk touch pick here. I'm gonna try and get one of those healing things. See if you can grab them or not. I checked the wiki and it didn't say, so we will find out here. So I'm very curious. Oh, don't look at them. I do have armor on this time. Go up, go up this one. I'll try to be quick. Here he comes. Get out of here. Still safe. Infinity bow on this guy would be awesome. Aw, dang it. I probably should have waited to heal. Where is he? Okay, he's gonna try to get me from behind. Oh, and he did. Okay, here we go. This might kill me. Dang it! Okay, you can't grab him. It seems... great view of the place from up here. Oh, he's just so easy. They really should have made it so that you needed potions to beat this guy. Or to stay alive in here. Like, this is... yeah. Whatever. Anyway. Oh, my chickens are still alive. I bet you can hurt them, though. That's awesome. They're all over the place. Ah, get some! Yeah! Okay. Maybe we'll try to do the minecart thing again. Oh, yeah, my stuff's here. Okay, well, I'm going to make a minecart, storage minecart, put my stuff in, kill myself, and we'll do the next test. So for this next test, we're going to try fishing rod. Doesn't seem to work. Let's keep trying. I'll try it a few more times. Come swoop down. And, nope, I got too far away that time. That'd be pretty crazy if it actually worked. Uh-oh. Thought I looked at him. Come on, get down here. Oh, I missed. Oh, I think it did work there. Or else he just did a swoop. It looked like I pulled him down. The freaking Enderman stole my dirt block. What are you I'm at it. Oh, dang. Uh-oh, I hit the dragon. Okay. Where is he? World's longest boss fight. Nope. No, it's not working. Okay. Oh, it works on minecarts. Oh, and it does pull them. I didn't know that. That's cool. Doesn't work on the dragon. Okay. Okay, so fishing rods don't seem to work on them. I'm going to try one more thing yet today. I would like to try snow golems in the end here and see what happens, but I don't have any, actually, so maybe some other time. But this next thing I want to do, our y-coordinate is around 60 right now. I want to see what happens if you get all the way down to, like, zero. If he will chase you down there or not, I'm curious to see. So, I'm going to hit him one more time before I try this. Okay. This is going to be really tough to do. I'll have to probably make several attempts at it, I would imagine. Basically, I gotta build my way down. Oh, there he is. And, nope. Yeah, he got me. I knew that was gonna happen. Okay, I'm gonna make another attempt here. I'm just gonna try to hit him one time. If I can, nope. Alright, I'm just gonna go for it. Just doing a few blocks at a time. I think when I get down to the bottom, he'll stop chasing me. Maybe. That's what I'm hoping. Oh, I'm not falling down fast enough. Two, three, four. I got five done. Oh, he just missed me. Oh, and he breaks the water too. look what he did. Not in the mood, guys. Not in the mood. Here we go again. Quicker. So I'm using obsidian because he can't break obsidian. Could use endstone too, but doesn't really matter. I got a lot of obsidian from mining, so I don't mind using it. Oh. Is that the bottom? That seemed to... I find that hard to believe that was the bottom already. Okay, this is it. I'm gonna go again. And we'll find out if that's the bottom or not, I guess. It is. Wow, that came quicker than I thought it would. Oh, he broke my water. So yeah, this is as low as you can get, I guess. I'm gonna start a new life here. Skyblock survival, Etho style. So I'm gonna see if he will hit me down here. If he doesn't, that means I can actually build in the end without having to kill him. Which I would do for reasons I don't understand myself. That is pretty cool, though. I like this. I seem to be safe. Yeah, he's not coming for me down here. Which makes me wonder how high I can get before he will start attacking me and destroying my stuff. Let's get a little bit higher here. Let's go up to 10 and just try hover here for a bit. Oh, he came down. See, I was wondering what would happen. I thought maybe he would fly down and somehow get messed up if he went below zero or something. I don't know. So he will attack if you're at 10. Actually, what I should do is just go AFK down at the bottom for a while and see what happens. Oh, there he is again. Yes, I'm going to go AFK here for a bit and see if I get knocked off. Yeah, he did get me. It took him about 2 minutes or so before he found me, but he did eventually find me and kill me. So, I don't know, I guess that means I have no choice. I gotta kill him. You know, what else can I do? Height doesn't seem to matter. Distance doesn't seem to matter. He'll just keep breaking my stuff if I build anything, so I gotta kill him. He didn't give me any choice. And I think that's what we will do maybe next time, I don't know. I'm gonna try to get a whole bunch of potions together, more storage minecarts, maybe some TNT, enchanted stuff, all kinds of fun things. I'm gonna get them all to the end, prepare for a big battle, and then I'm gonna make a backup of my world just before I fight them, and I'll probably release it for you guys if you want to try fight them with all that stuff, and maybe I'll kill them several times and just keep loading the backup, I don't know. Have some fun with it. That is the plan. I do have to kill them. Can't think of any other way of keeping them alive and doing what I want. So, that's what we'll do. But for today, I'm going to say goodbye. I'll see you guys again next time. I never did really explore this area yet. I should do that sometime. Okay, see ya.